All right, kia ora everyone. You've probably been hearing a lot about Model Context Protocol, MCP, and that you can now use this with Dataverse in the Power Platform. So I'm going to take you step by step through how to set this up so you can start playing around with MCP. I've tried this myself. It is super, super cool. So let's get into it. Now, first things first, there are some prerequisites. There's some things you're going to need to install in order to be able to do this. So firstly, you're going to need a Dataverse environment. Feels self-evident, but you will need this. And within this, you're going to need to be able to create a connector to Dataverse in the make.powerautomate portal. I'll show you that shortly. You're also going to need to be able to grab the tenant ID for your Dataverse environment from the Maker portal. You're going to need VS Code because we're going to have to run some terminal windows. And you're going to need to download Claude Desktop. Now, this is all in the Microsoft docs. So let's pop over there and let's start getting into it. All right. So this is the place in the Microsoft docs. I will pop this URL in the video description so you can get there. But this is where you've got all the instructions to connect to Dataverse with MCP. Now, as we scroll through this, the first option is to use this in Copilot Studio. Now, we are going to skip this for now because you actually have to set up an MCP server, which I haven't quite figured out yet. So let's skip past this. And what we want to do is we want to go here to connect to Dataverse with Claude and GitHub Copilot and VS Code. All right, so the first thing we need to do is we need to set up this connection to Dataverse. And so we're going to come here into the Power Automate Maker portal. So you're going to go to make.powerautomate.com. Don't do this in make.power apps, do it in make.power automate. Come to connections here on the side. Click new connection and Dataverse. Now I'm not going to go and create one because I've already got one, but that's what you're going to do. So we'll come down here to the connection I've already created. And all we need is this URL here. We're going to copy and paste that later. So that's the first thing you need to set up. All right, the next thing we need to do once we have created this connection to Dataverse is we need to install MCP locally on our machine. And we get the instructions here. Now, this is where VS Code comes in. And so there's a couple of PowerShell commands you need to run. Now, I'm not going to run these at the moment because I've already installed this. But what you're going to do is you're going to come here to Terminal and say New Terminal, and then you're going to run the command. Now, I installed this earlier. This is really embarrassing. I don't actually know how to change this directory in VS Code. If somebody knows how to do it, drop it in the comments. But when I run the command, I get it's already installed. So I'll spare you that. But these are the two commands that you need to run. So you'll run this first. Once that's installed, you need to kill the terminal window, reboot VS Code, and then run this one. And that should get MCP all installed for you locally on your machine. All right, the next thing you need is the tenant of your Dataverse environment. And so if we come over here to the Maker portal, and what you're going to do is click on the sprocket here in the upper right-hand corner, click Session Details, and you'll get that right here, tenant ID. And you're going to need that along with the URL to your Dataverse connector to set up the MCP connection to Dataverse. All right, next you're going to need Claude Desktop. Now, hopefully you've already installed this, but if not, you can get that right here. Just click and download that. It's a quick, easy install. Then we're now ready to start working with these details that we've set up, our connection to Dataverse, our tenant ID, all that cool stuff. So you're going to come here to Claude Desktop, and you're going to click on File and Settings. Now, this is not in the docs, but what you actually want to do is you want to click here on Developer and Edit Config. And what this is going to do is this is going to open up your config file for the MCP connection. So let's go ahead and open this. I've set it up to open in VS Code. And when you initially get this, all you're going to see is a pair of curly brackets. That's all that's going to be in there. This bit is going to be added by you, but don't worry, it's super, super easy. So let's come back to the docs and we'll scroll down. And this is the JSON that we want. And Microsoft have made it super easy. Just copy this to your clipboard and then come back to VS Code and paste it in. But we're not done yet. We've still got to make some updates. And there are three things that we need to update here. So the first thing is the friendly name. So if we come back here to the docs, you'll notice that the boilerplate here is friendly name. Now, when I first did this, I left it blank and it didn't work. So you want to make sure that you update this. So we'll come back to VS Code. Now, I've just called this Nathan Dataverse. Call it anything you like, just make sure that you update it. The next thing is you need this connection URL for your Dataverse connector that you created in Power Automate. It's a simple copy-paste. So here in Power Automate, just copy this URL right here, the whole thing, and then paste that in here in VS Code. And then the last thing is your tenant ID that you grabbed from your Dataverse environment. So we'll come back here to the Maker portal, just copy paste this value, and then come back here to VS Code and copy paste it in where it says tenant ID. Leave this one with the two dashes and come back here to the docs. So leave this one and where you've got the brackets and it says tenant ID GUID, paste it in there. Now, once you've done that, back in VS Code, what you want to do is you want to click File and Save. That's going to save this configuration. And then in Claude, what you want to do is you want to click File and Exit. And then we're going to restart Claude. Now, at this point, you're either going to get an error if you've got a problem, but if you followed these steps, you should be fine. And what we see down here is I'm connected to the MCP server. Now, the first time you do this, it's going to put up a prompt like anytime you log into XRM Toolbox or any other tool where it's going to ask you for your creds to log into Dataverse. Go ahead and enter those and then you should be sweet. Now, this lets us do a lot of things. We can list tables. We can create queries, we can create records, update records, a bunch of things we can do. Now I'm going to take you through three quick ones. What we'll do is we will do a quick query, we'll have it build a chart for us, and then we'll create and update a record. So actually it's four, take your pick. All right, so let's start with a simple one. How many contacts do I have in Dataverse? So it's taken my natural language. It's putting a request together. And so we've got an OData, and it looks like this OData gets converted into SQL, which ultimately becomes fetch XML. And it says that we have 240 records in Dataverse, 240 contacts. Well, let's verify that. Let's come over here to Dataverse and do a quick refresh. Yes, we have 240 contacts. Very, very cool. How many contacts are in Auckland? Let's see if it can do this. I haven't asked it this before, so let's see how it does. It's looking at the contact. It's putting together a query, checking the city. Look at that. And it says we have 26 contacts in Auckland. All right, let's verify this. So let's come over here. Let's edit our filters. Let's add in address one city and let's type in Auckland and apply. And look at that. We have 26 records in Auckland. So MCP was able to take my natural language query, how many contacts are in Auckland, stuff that we traditionally have used advanced find for, and it's created that for me. All right. Let's do something else. I am terrible at charts in Dataverse Power Platform. Like, if you want to see me cry, ask me to do a chart. I am really, really bad at it. So let's say create a pie chart showing contacts by city. If the city is null, include them as well. All right, let's see what this does. So it's putting together my query. That looks like SQL to me. It's gotten a response. And now it's putting together a chart. And this looks like some kind of, not sure if this is fetch XML or HTML or what it is, but it is putting together a chart for us on the fly, which is very, very cool. And look at that, we have a chart based on our query. 173 contacts, no city. Look at that. Auckland, 26. Well, we just verified that. Very cool. So look at that, a chart from a very simple query. This is something, I just did this in seconds. This used to take like, I mean, it took me forever, but you know, somebody who's actually good at charts, it would probably take them at least half an hour to do this by the time you put together your query and you go through the chart WYSIWYG and all that stuff. And I just did it in seconds from natural language. So hopefully you're starting to get the power of MCP with Dataverse. All right, let's create a record. So let's say create a contact record. First name MCP, last name test. Let's see what it does. A little too excited there. And there we go. Huh. Ah. I've exceeded the length limit. Let's try new chat. So it's probably because I'm using the free version because I'm cheap. So create a contact, first name equals MCP, last name equals test. All right, so it's going through. Looks like it's doing its thing. We've got a response. It's going to create this in the contact. It's found the contact. It's now, and it's found the columns that I've specified, so first name and last name, and it's now creating the record. And it says it's created a record, and it's even given me the ID. All right, let's come back here to our, let's change this to created on. Let's change this to today. And here we go, MCP test. We have just created this record. Very cool. All right, let's update this record. Let's come back here and let's say update the, helps if you spell it right, update the record you just created with email, MCP test at nocodenomercy.com. All right, so it's going through its thing. It's found the record, doing the update, and it's updated it. All right, let's come back here. So you can see we've got a null value for the email. Let's do a quick refresh. And look at that. We have done that. We have updated the record from Claude using MCP. So I hope this is starting to give you an idea of what's possible. So it is super, super easy to set up this MCP connection to Dataverse using Claude. Honestly, it shouldn't take you more than 20 minutes if you follow the docs, follow the steps in the video, and then you can start to get an idea for what's possible with natural language with your data. So I am like a kid in the candy store at the moment. This is incredibly exciting. I hope you get a chance to play with this because this is unbelievable. This, I mean, you know, I'm struggling to use my words at the moment. I'm so excited, but the possibilities of what we can do with this are limitless. All right, go do something awesome on the Power Platform today, and I will talk to you all soon.